Good morning, students. This is 12th standard botany video class, video 12. In this video, we are going to continue the lesson, chromosomal basis of inheritance. Dear students, in the previous video class, we have seen structural changes in chromosome, that is structural chromosomal aberration, which is divided into two types. One is changes in the number of gene loci. Another one is the changes in the arrangement of gene loci. First one divided into two types, deletion and duplication. Then the second one divided into inversion and translocation. Deletion, that means loss of portion of your chromosome, is called deletion, divided into two, terminal and intercalary. So deletion of a segment in the tip region of any one of the site is known as terminal. The deletion taken place in the middle, that is known as intercalary deletion. Next one, duplication. The arrangement of same order of a gene repeated more than once in the same chromosome is known as duplication. It is again divided into three types, tandem, displaced tandem and reverse tandem. So those are all the three types of duplication which leads to evolutionary sequence. Another one, inversion type, that is arrangement in gene loci. The rearrangement of order of a gene in a chromosome by reversed by an angle 180 degree is known as inversion, divided into two types, paracentric and pericentric. Inversion changes occur apart from the centromere region is known as paracentric. The inversion changes occur including centromere is known as pericentric inversion. Next one, translocation. Transfer of a segment of chromosome to a non-homologous chromosome is known as translocation, divided into simple, shift and reciprocal translocation. Simple translocation means a broken segment is get attached. One end of the non-homologous chromosome is known as simple. And the shift one, broken segment is inserted interstitially in a non-homologous chromosome is known as shift translocation. That means it's not automatically exchange the segments, by artificially we are inserted any one of the region of a chromosome is known as shift translocation. Then reciprocal, that means mutual exchange of segments between the chromosome is known as reciprocal translocation or illegitimate crossing over. It is divided into homozygous and heterozygous. Both the pair of homologous chromosome exchanging the segments is known as homozygous. Heterozygous means two of the chromosome which are remaining the original one, other remaining two only which are exchanging the segment is known as heterozygous translocation. So this translocation type of aberration is also leads to form a new species. Dear students, up to this only we have seen in the previous video class. In this video, we are going to start the new topic, that is DNA metabolism in plants. Dear students, this is the diagram which you have seen in the previous video class, that is deletion chromosomal aberration. Then this is the another diagram which we have seen in the previous video class, that is duplication and its types. So this is the inversion diagram, that is the changing of the segments is taken place at 180 degree angle to rearrange the segments, that is said to be inversion, and its type paracentric and pericentric inversion. Then this one is the translocation of chromosomal structure, which are showing two type, heterozygous, that means the rearrangement of segments taken place in two pair of chromosome in homozygous, but in the heterozygous the exchanging of segment has taken place only between the two non-homologous chromosome, other two are showing the original one. So this is said to be translocation type. Up to this only we have seen in the previous video class. Today we are going to see the topic DNA replication. Dear students, this is the structure of DNA, double-stranded helix, which is made up of polynucleotide sequence, which consists of nitrogenous bases, that is purine and pyrimidine. Adenine and guanine are known as purine. Cytosine and thymine are known as pyrimidine. Then they are joined with sugar molecule and also phosphate group, which constitute the nitrogenous base pair, which constitute the polynucleotide DNA structure, which is present in the eukaryotic organisms. This DNA, how it's showing the metabolic activities in plants, that one only we are going to see in this topic, that is DNA metabolism in plants. This DNA metabolism is taken place in three steps. One is DNA replication, DNA repair, and recombinant DNA. So these are all the three steps taken place in DNA metabolism in plants. First, we are going to see what is DNA replication, then DNA repair, then recombinant DNA. Dear students, in the plant cell, it contains many macromolecules. Out of these macromolecules, DNA only, which are having the genetic material, it is a unique character or special character which carries the information from parental to the next generation. So thus, the structure of DNA is a device which are showing the genetic information. The term DNA metabolism is used to describe that how DNA, which are taking replication along with DNA repair and recombination. So that is said to be DNA metabolism. The DNA is a double-stranded helix which was first discovered by the scientists Watson and Crick. So this model of DNA is known as Watson-Crick model of DNA, which is made up of polynucleotide sequence, made up of sugar molecule, phosphate group, and nitrogenous base pair such as adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Adenine and guanine are known as purine. Cytosine and thymine are pyrimidine. Adenine always combined with thymine. Cytosine always combined with guanine. So this is the general structure of DNA. This DNA, how it's going to be produced another DNA, that process is called replication of DNA, which was observed in the prokaryotic bacteria, that is Escherichia coli bacteria, along with how DNA changing the repair parts of nucleotide segments, how it is produced the newly formed recombinant DNA. These are all the three steps which is taken place in DNA metabolism. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the DNA metabolism in plants. First, we are going to see DNA replication. Replication means newly formed DNA strand, how it is produced in the parental DNA. That is said to be DNA replication. The DNA parental one which consists of two strand, that is double helix model of DNA. First separate, and each parental strand which produce a newly formed complementary strand, that is pair of a parental strand, that is known as DNA replication. DNA replication is plant is known as semi-conservative. That means the newly formed DNA molecules which contains two strand, double strand, one of the strand which resembles the parental one, the another one only is named as recombinant. That's why this type of metabolism is known as semi-conservative DNA replication. Dear students, next one is the DNA repair. The repairing process of DNA is also unique character which is seen only the macromolecule of DNA. This DNA only has the capacity to repair the worn out parts in the DNA sequence which recognize the damaged part and removes the damaged pair with the help of mutational process. That is said to be DNA repair. This DNA repair is subjected to two type of mutation. One is the spontaneous repair, that is automatically taken place or naturally taken place in the DNA itself. Another one due to environmental factor or environmental agents or natural endogenous threat is also subject to the damaging parts of DNA. That damages are repaired by DNA is known as DNA repair. Dear students, the damages which is caused by naturally, that is spontaneously, and environmental factors which are corrected by the repair enzymes and proteins which is present in the DNA. So these repair are immediately repaired after the damage has taken place. In DNA metabolism, DNA repair plays an important role which maintaining the genetic or genomic integration of an organism. And also this DNA repair system protect the DNA genomes from genotoxic stresses. So it maintaining the genetic material which is present inner side of the DNA. Not only that, it protect the DNA against DNA gene against genotoxic stresses. That is said to be DNA repair. Dear students, some plants are sessile. How they protect themselves from the exposure of sunlight throughout the day? Plants which have the effective DNA repair mechanism to prevent ultraviolet damage from sunlight. For that, the DNA which are produced the enzyme called photolyase, which can repair the thymine dimer and restore the structure of DNA. So the thymine dimer only which cause repair in the DNA, that should be replaced by the enzyme is known as photolyase and restore the structure of original DNA. That is the points given in the do you know paragraph. That means the DNA which are having the special enzyme is called photolyase, which prevent from ultraviolet damage from the sunlight. So this DNA repair the thymine dimer and restore the structure of DNA. That's why plants which are protect themselves from the ultraviolet damage from sunlight. The next step of DNA mechanism is recombination. First one, we have seen DNA replication. Another one, DNA repair. The next one is the recombination. The genetic material which is present inside of the DNA molecule, which are rearranged by a process, is known as genetic recombination. This genetic recombination is taken place as a result of crossing over between the pair of homologous chromosomes during meiotic cell division. So this recombination process and recombination frequency, everything we have seen earlier in this lesson. Now, how this recombination of DNA is taken place? In the molecular level, this recombination involves breakage and reunion of polynucleotides. Dear students, in the video starting class itself, I told you, DNA is a double-stranded helix model made up of polynucleotide sequence. So, the breakage in the polynucleotide sequence and the reunion of the polynucleotide sequence in molecular level is known as recombination. So these are all the three steps which is taken place in DNA metabolism in plants. Now we are going to see DNA replication in detailed manner. Dear students, replication in eukaryotic DNA. Dear students, this replication processes start at a specific site is known as origin of replication. Each and every organism which are consist of DNA, which is double-stranded helix, which are having the specific site for replication, that is known as origin of replication. In eukaryotic DNA, there contains more than one origin of replication site. For example, the Saccharomyces cerevisiae is the prokaryotic organism, yeast. Approximately it contains 400 origin of replication. Underline the one mark question. We are studying about the eukaryotic DNA replication only, but they are giving the comparative study of eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic DNA, which contains more than one origin of replication. Another one, prokaryotic DNA, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, yeast contains 400 origin of replication. This DNA replication is start with the region is known as pre-replication complex. They are assembled together, which consists of 14 different proteins. In this region only, the DNA replication is start in eukaryotic organism. What is the region for DNA replication? Pre-replication complex assembly, which contains how many protein molecules? 14 different protein molecules. In that pre-replication complex part, a small region is known as ORC, that means origin of replication complex, which contains 6 protein. This origin of replication complex only is the initiator, that means to initiate the DNA replication process. This ORC, which is present in a small part of pre-replication complex, and this ORC, which contains how many protein molecules? 6 protein molecules. So this ORC act as a initiator of DNA replication is another important one mark question. Likewise, the prokaryotic cell Saccharomyces cerevisiae, which contain the replication sequences, are known as ARS, that means automatically replicating sequences. In this ARS, the ORC is also bind together. ORC was identified as a protein complex which binds directly to the ARS elements. Okay, so this is the difference between eukaryotic DNA replication starting stage as well as the prokaryotic cell named Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Dear students, now we are going to see the replication of DNA. Dear students, replication fork is the site. That means the point which is going to be separate the DNA strand, that is 5-strand and 3-strand, from the parental DNA, which produce new daughter DNA strand are formed, that is said to be replication fork. In eukaryotic cell, many replication forks are present, that is known as multiple replication forks. The double-stranded DNA helix, see the diagram. The right side, the blue color strand is said to be double-stranded DNA, which is unwinding by the enzyme is known as helicase, which is in the violet color oval-shaped structure is known as helicase enzyme, which separate the parental double-stranded DNA into two daughter strand DNA fork. How this helicase, which separate the parental DNA into two daughter DNA fork, means it breaks the hydrogen bond which is present between the nitrogenous bases. That means adenine always combined with thymine with the help of two hydrogen bonds. Likewise, cytosine is binded with guanine with the three hydrogen bonds. So these hydrogen bonds are broken by the enzyme helicase and make the double-stranded parental DNA into single-stranded newly formed daughter fork. Then this two strand of DNA is produced by the breaking of hydrogen bonds, and the replication protein A prevents the polynucleate strand from reunited. See the diagram. The pink color oval shaped structure is said to be RPA. What is that one? Replication protein A. So this replication protein A, which prevents the polynucleate sequence to reunited. Helicase, which breaks the hydrogen bonds and separate the parental DNA into two daughter strand DNA. See the blue color, left side one and right side one in a V-shaped form. Okay. At the same time, a protein which is present in the daughter strand, what is that one? RPA, replication protein A, which prevents the polynucleotide sequence reunion. So that is the newly formed replication forks are produced by the unwinding process of parental DNA by the enzyme helicase. Dear students, in the previous para, we have seen the replication fork of eukaryotic DNA by the enzyme helicase, which are unwinding the parental DNA into two replication fork by breaking the hydrogen bond, and also the DNA which contains, that is newly formed daughter DNA which contains the protein replication protein A, prevents the separated polynucleotide strand from getting reattached, that means reunited. That is the function of helicase enzyme which is present in the DNA replication. Dear students, now we are going to see the another enzyme named topoisomerase. This is an enzyme which breaks the DNA's covalent bond and removes positive supercoiling agate of replication fork. Dear students, one side the helicase which separate the parental DNA strand into two daughter strand fork. Okay, so see the diagram. At the base they are having the double stranded helix. At the tip they are having the single stranded newly formed daughter strand. Then one side it's separating the strand. Another side the parental DNA which are going to be super coiled. அதிகமான அளவுக்கு முறுக்கிக்கும். ஓகேயா? ஸோ விச் இஸ் டேக்கன் பிளேஸ் இன் த பேரண்டல் டிஎன்ஏ தட் ஷுட் பி பிரேக்ஸ் பை த என்சைம் இஸ் கால்டு டோபாய்சோமெரேஸ். திஸ் டோபாய்சோமெரேஸ் விச் பிரேக்ஸ் த டிஎன்ஏ கோவலண்ட் பாண்ட் அண்ட் ரிமூவ்ஸ் பாசிட்டிவ் சூப்பர் காயிலிங் அகேட் ஆஃப் ரெப்ளிகேஷன் ஃபோக். அண்ட் ஆல்சோ This topoisomerase eliminate the torsional stress caused by unwinding of DNA double helix. So sometimes this torsional stress is caused at the time of eukaryotic replication. That the stress is removed by the enzyme is called topoisomerase. So the two function is done by the enzyme topoisomerase. One is it breaks the covalent bond of DNA and removes the positive supercoiling ahead of replication of a fork, and also it prevent from the DNA by torsional stress. This is the function of topoisomerase. This is the second enzyme which is responsible for DNA replication. Another enzyme is known as DNA polymerase. So dear students, see the paragraph, the function of topoisomerase, the enzyme which breaks the covalent bond in DNA and also removes the positive supercoiling replication fork from the daughter strand of DNA. Then it eliminates the stress caused by unwinding of DNA double helix. Next, we are going to see the another enzyme, DNA polymerase. So DNA replication is initiated by an enzyme is known as DNA polymerase A primase, which synthesizes short stretch of RNA primer on both leading strand and lagging strand. That means the newly formed strands are known as two strand. One is the leading strand, another one is the lagging strand. Leading strand which are showing the continuous DNA replication, but the lagging strand which are showing the discontinuous DNA replication. So in this DNA replication is initiated by an enzyme is known as DNA polymerase A and primase. So this primase which synthesize the another enzyme is known as RNA primer on both the leading strand and the lagging strand. The primer is very much important. There is RNA primer is very much important because the DNA polymerase requires a free 3 strand OH to initiate synthesis. That means the DNA polymerase requires the free 3 strand hydroxyl group to initiate the DNA synthesis, so that the DNA polymerase covalently connect the nucleotides at the growing end of new DNA strand. So the two function is taken place. One is the primase which are produce RNA primer, another one is the DNA polymerase. The DNA polymerase require RNA primer in the free 3-strand, that means newly formed free 3-strand, to initiate the synthesis of hydroxyl group. At the same time, the DNA polymerase which connect the nucleotide sequence which is present in the newly formed DNA strand. So these are all the two functions of enzymes, DNA polymerase A and RNA primer which is produced by the enzyme known as primase. Dear students, this DNA polymerase is again divided into different enzymes involved in DNA replication. One is DNA polymerase A, that is alpha, DNA polymerase delta, and DNA polymerase epsilon are the three enzymes which is responsible for nuclear DNA replication. First one, DNA polymerase alpha, synthesizes a short primer of RNA. That one we have seen in the paragraph. That means the DNA polymerase A, that means alpha, otherwise known as primase, which are producing the short segment, is known as RNA primer. Another one, DNA polymerase delta, which is replicating the enzymes of cell nucleus. That means the nucleus which contain different enzymes, that enzymes are replicated by the RNA polymerase, is known as delta. Another one, DNA polymerase epsilon, which extend the DNA strands in the replication fork. That means the newly formed daughter strand is extended by an enzyme, is known as DNA polymerase epsilon. So these are all the three enzymes which is involved in the nuclear DNA replication. Dear students, see the diagram. The newly formed strand which containing two strand, one is the leading strand. See the topmost strand which are forming the newly replicated strand with a daughter strand. That is said to be leading strand. We are coming to the another side. The newly formed strand which are showing the discontinuous replication. That strand is known as lagging strand template. So two template is there. That means newly formed strand, leading strand, another one is the lagging strand. Okay. Then see the DNA polymerase, different DNA polymerase. Polymerase DNA alpha, which is responsible for synthesis of RNA primer in three strand. See the diagram. That is the yellow color, a small shape is attached to the DNA polymerase. What is that one? RNA primer produced by the DNA polymerase A in the leading strand. Likewise, the another enzyme, DNA polymerase, that is delta, which is responsible for replicating the enzyme in the nucleus. Another one, DNA polymerase epsilon, which is present in the leading strand, which is responsible for the extension of a strand in the leading strand of template. So this is the three type of DNA polymerase responsible for the DNA replication. Dear students, another DNA polymerase is also there, that is known as beta. So this DNA polymerase does not play a role in the replication of normal DNA function, but its function is removing the incorrect pairs or bases from the damaged DNA. So it is involved in base excision repair. So the DNA repair is responsible by the enzyme is known as DNA polymerase beta. But this beta do not play a role in the replication of normal DNA. It removes the damaged part of DNA. Dear students, the newly formed DNA synthesis is taken place in two directions. One is the 5-strand, another one is the 3-strand direction. It is semi-discontinuous. Why it's said to be semi-discontinuous? That means the newly formed DNA molecule conserves one original strand, another one is said to be the newly formed strand. So that is said to be semi-discontinuous or semi-conservative. When DNA is synthesized in 5-strand to 3-strand direction, only in the free 3-strand end DNA is elongated. That means in the free C strand end which are having the hydroxyl group, that group only which are showing the replication and also elongation of DNA. First we are taking the DNA synthesized in 5 strand and 3 strand direction. See the position. Because 2 strand is there, one side 5, another side 3, isn't it? So the direction is in 5 strand and 3 strand. The free 3 end of hydroxyl group only elongated. The another side, the replication of a DNA is discontinuous. This was observed by the scientist Reiji Okazaki and its friends in the year 1960. The newly formed DNA strand, which are synthesized in the form of short pieces, that is named after the scientist Okazaki. That fragments are named as Okazaki fragments. In discontinuous strand, where the Okazaki fragments are united by enzyme is known as DNA ligase, is called a lagging strand template, where the replication direction is 5 strand to 3 strand, which is opposite to the direction of fork movement. The continuous strand is known as leading strand, where the replication direction is 5 strand to 3 strand, which is same to the direction to that of the replication fork of movement. The DNA ligase join any nicks in DNA by forming the phosphodiester bond between 3-strand hydroxyl and 5-strand phosphate group. Dear students, see the diagram. So at the base, the shape is look like in the form of Y shape. At the base only they are having the parental strand. Then they are replicated into 2-strand, 5-strand leading to the 3-strand. And the 3-strand leading to the 5-strand. Then these 2 new daughter strand again replicated to produce the leading strand and the lagging strand. The 3-strand which are producing the 5-strand, which are continuously showing the replication fork. The other side, the 3-strand of the another one which are not having the OH group, which showing the discontinuous, see the arrow mark, vittu vittu vandirukku paarenga, discontinuous, that is said to be lagging strand. So this lagging strand which are connected by a enzyme is known as DNA ligase. These fragments are known as Okazaki fragments. Thus the lagging strand which are connected by a fragments using the enzyme DNA ligase and produce the newly formed strand. So the replication fork taken place between 5 strand to 3 strand, there is no discontinuous. They are continuously producing the newly formed double stranded helix of replication fork, that is known as leading strand. The replication taken place between 5 strand and 3 strand is showing the discontinuous process. The DNA fragments are with a short length. Those fragments are known as Okazaki fragments, connected by a enzyme is known as DNA ligase, which connects the fragments forming a phosphodiester group between 3-strand OH group and 5-strand hydroxyl. 3-strand hydroxyl group, that is OH, and 5-strand phosphate group, forming the phosphodiester. That's why the lagging strand is otherwise leads into a newly formed daughter strand. So this is the process which has taken place, how DNA showing the replication process. Dear students, see the diagram, the lagging strand template. This is the 5-strand, is the original one. That is daughter strand. 3-strand, which are showing the red color, there is no continuous. They are showing the discontinuous, and the DNA are in the form of fragments. These fragments are connected by a enzyme. See that yellow color diagram showing the DNA ligase, which joins the fragments known as Okazaki fragments. In a lagging strand template, produce the continuous replication fork. In the another one, leading strand template, there is no discontinuous of formation of nucleotide sequence. So here there is no ligase enzyme, but in the another side only we are showing the fragments. So these fragments are connected by a DNA ligase, producing polydiester strand. What is the polydiester? 3-strand hydroxyl group, that is OH, which is combined with a 5-strand phosphatase group, which are forming phosphodiester group, which connects the DNA fragments or Okazaki fragments. Thus, a newly formed double-stranded helix DNA, which is produced from the parental DNA, is known as eukaryotic replication of DNA or eukaryotic replication fork. Dear students, I hope have you all understood what is DNA replication, DNA repair, recombinant DNA, how eukaryotic cell, which are showing the DNA replication. After this, I conclude my video. Remaining, we will see in the next video class. God bless you. All the best, children.